Annyeong Hasu, and welcome to Awful Advent, a countdown of 13 holiday horror movies for the 13 days before Christmas. Our third film this year is a scrappy indie about a university overrun by the undead. It's A Cadaver Christmas! After a blood-soaked janitor shows up at a local bar on Christmas Eve, the bartender, his patron, a cop, and the janitor head to the university to confirm his story of reanimated cadavers. A Cadaver Christmas is a scrappy little flick where you can feel the limitations the filmmakers are both working against and with. It's obviously a low-budget film, but you have the sense that this worked to their advantage. The movie's setting of an abandoned campus on winter break is good in that it allows for a visually interesting place to shoot, while also justifying a complete lack of extras and background characters. The movie is also a tongue-in-cheek homage to the old grindhouse movies from the 70s, with copious amounts of gore and ridiculous violence when fighting the zombies.
Cadavers!
Right, sorry. Cadavers. The DIY aesthetic of the production even carries through into the story being told on screen. Just as the characters have to cobble together a zombie response plan with the limited resources available to them, the filmmakers had to build this movie from limited resources as well. However, the weaknesses of the movie are where the aesthetics cross the line into affectations. For example, I said this was a grindhouse homage, and the movie makes the mistake a lot of the homages from the period made of digitally adding film artifacts like scratches and bad splices. It doesn't make the film look older, it just looks like digital noise. Likewise, the characters are all stock types, the hot-headed cop, the gruff working-class hero, the bumbling comic relief drunk, which is fine, but they're played poorly on purpose. These movies used to have bad actors, so, in trying to get the aesthetic of bad actors, the actors are acting badly. The former is an aesthetic, the latter is an affectation, and it can grow tiresome. Which is a shame, because even though I didn't enjoy the movie as much this time as I usually do, it's still relentlessly charming, and the comedy remains clever and inventive, while also being silly and childish, and I mean that in the best possible way. It's a solid concept that's well executed within its limitations. You just need to watch it the right way. For several years, the filmmakers held a holiday party where they'd screen the film, and that's the way to watch this, with a bunch of friends getting twisted on Nog while exchanging gifts. Watching it alone, as I did, just reminds you of what you'd rather be doing, and this is a movie that's worth watching right. 3 out of 5 custodians crushing Christmas cadaver craniums. Tomorrow we'll look at another indie about the undead, the miracle of Christmas, and the most famous haunted house in all of horror. Until then, stay safe, stay inside, and stay spooky.